Welcome back to the class, children. So in the previous classes we have learned about three forms of water: solid form, liquid form and gaseous form. Then we have also learned about evaporation, condensation. And evaporation is a process of heating and condensation is a process of cooling. And here we have learned how clouds are formed and how they become cool. And now today we are going to learn how the cooled water which is there in clouds, how do they fall down as rain. So page number 26. So here down I am reading. So we all know that without clouds it will not be possible to get rains, and that all clouds do not cause rain. Some changes take place in the clouds before they cause rain. So what changes are those? So we know that clouds are going to give us rain. Now you just go out and see how is the sky. It is like it's not that much cloudy. It is like blue in color and white in color. So if it is like that, it will not rain. If it is gray in color, then only it's going to rain. But do all the gray color clouds they give the rain? No. Sometimes they give the rain and sometimes they do not give the rain. So there are some changes in the clouds before it starts raining. So what are the changes? Let us see. So what changes do you notice in the sky and in the atmosphere before it rains? So in the sky it starts thundering, then there is lot of wind. So you can see a windy climate also. So what changes takes place in the clouds before raining? So in the weather we know it, but in clouds we can't go up and see. So let us see what changes are there in the clouds also. So here is a picture of a rainy day. The clouds moving in the air are generally at higher levels. So whatever clouds you can see, sometimes they move with the wind. So they start moving. You can see as the sky is moving, but it's not that. The clouds are moving. So whatever the clouds are moving, they are at very large distance, very higher distance. Sometimes the cool breeze coming along with air makes the clouds cooler. This leads to water droplets present in the clouds to condense and form large water drops. Further, cooling of clouds increase the size of their water drops and clouds become heavy and dense towards the earth. The color of such clouds changes from white to gray, giving us the feel of dark clouds gathering. So what happens here is, how does the rain fall? So after the clouds are formed over there, because of the cool breeze, the water vapor will start changing into water. So as it is changing, all the water vapor, suddenly they will not change into water, right? So slowly they start changing into water. So as they change into water, they become into tiny water droplets. Then they become into huge water drop. So after changing like this, the cloud becomes heavy. What happens here? The cloud becomes heavy and they burst into rain and they start falling towards the earth. So why do they fall down? Because earth has gravitational force, that's why they start falling down. So you can see that the sky will be very clear in white in color and blue in color, and when the clouds start gathering, they become into gray in color. This is because of the water present inside the clouds. When the size of the water drops increase further, it becomes difficult for the cloud to hold them and water drops begin to fall, and this is known as rain. So when the water drops when the water vapor is changed into water drops, when the amount is very small and very little, it is easy for the cloud to hold the water. But when it is huge, when all the water vapor is changed into water, for the cloud it is very difficult to hold the water. So they start removing the water from the cloud and they start falling down. And this is, we call it as a rain. In our daily life, we observe that before raining clouds, descend towards the earth surface and we experience a cool breeze before rainfall. So before rainfall, what happens is the clouds, they slowly start coming down because they are cool and heavy. Heavy things, obviously, they pull towards the surface of the earth. So lighter clouds, they are above, little higher level, and cooler clouds, they will be towards the lower level of the earth. So because of that clouds, we can feel the cool breeze coming. So in very cold condition, the drop of water turns into crystals of ice and fall as snow. In some regions, what happens is we don't have snowfall here. But in few regions, what happens is because of very cold climatic conditions, the water vapor over there, it changes into water, and because of the cool climate, the water is changed into again ice cubes. So when it is falling, it will fall in the form of snow. Sometimes big drops of water solidify into ice and fall as pieces of ice known as hailstones. So this hailstones we experience it. Sometimes like instead of water, ice cubes will fall. Yes, you are very like, you know very well about this, and you just pick up that ice cubes also sometimes, isn't it? So we experience this type of hailstones, but we don't have the snowfall here. So along with the rain, sometimes we experience even the ice cubes also. So this type of rain, we call it as hailstones. So generally, we get rains in some particular months during the year. So generally, we have here during the June, July, August, September, and sometimes in October also. So in our state, Maine, the rain occurs normally from June to September. Yes. So during that season, you might have observed the sky clouds are moving along with the wind blowing from the western direction. So they are called as southwest side. So these winds are called as southwest monsoon. So generally during this season, what happens is the wind blows from the western side towards the southern side. So these winds we call as southwest monsoon. So this rains we call it as southwest monsoon. So not only these rains, but we experience rain in few other months also. Let us see what are those. Similarly, we observe in the month of November, December, rain occurs due to the movement of clouds in the direction of wind blowing from eastern side, and they are called as northeast monsoon. So not only in July, August and September, in November and December also we feel the rains, but in very light, little limit we feel it. So during that time, the wind blows towards the northeast direction. The wind blows from the northeast direction, and those rains we call it as northeast monsoon. We call them as northeast monsoon. So nowadays we are not getting timely rains, and seasons are also changing slightly. So think why it is happening so. Yes, generally before 10 years and 15 years, we used to get the summer season used to start in the month of February and March. But now from January only, there are so many heat. Summer season has started, and rainy season would start in the month of June. But now because of the environment, the rains, we experience the rain sometimes in March, in April, and sometimes even in May also. So why the seasons are changing? Let us see. So here is a water cycle. So when it rains, ponds, lakes, etc. are again filled with water. So whatever water is evaporating from the lakes, ponds and all, it goes up, condenses, forms clouds, the rain, and again this rainwater, they reach to the ponds and lakes. So water from rainfall runs down as small streams. These small streams join together and make little bigger streams. So these bigger streams join the rivers. So here also from one road, a small line will come streams. So these all streams, they join and they become little bigger. Then they join into a lake, and then from that lake they go into a river. So like this, from one form to other form, they again become bigger. These bigger streams join the rivers. The rivers flow down to seas and the oceans. Some of these rain water seeps into the ground and become as the ground water. So not the complete rain water goes into ocean, seas and rivers. So the ground also absorbs the water. So whatever water is absorbed by the ground, they go deep into the water and they change into the underground water. As it is very hot during summer, large quantity of water vapor from seas, lakes, rivers, etc. are converted into water vapor. This goes up into the air to form clouds. These clouds again cool down and produce the air. So during summer season, because of the hot climate, the water gets evaporated and it will change into water vapor. Then again it is cooled down and it comes as the rain. So that is the water cycle which they have given in the picture number 12. The circulation of water into water vapor by evaporation and water vapor to clouds and clouds to rain by condensation is called as water cycle. So water cycle is nothing but something similar to a life cycle of human beings. So here the water vapor from lakes, it goes and forms clouds. Again from clouds, it condenses and becomes rain. And from this rain, the water goes into lakes. So from lakes, again it is evaporated, and they go up and they form clouds. And the clouds, they condense, that is make them cool, and they fall down as rain. From these rains, they join the lakes. Again lakes, they evaporate and they make as clouds. So this is a continuous process. So this complete process we call it as water cycle. This cycle of evaporation and condensation takes place continuously in the nature. So this is a continuous process. It is not going to stop. So deforestation and pollution from factories are now causing global warming. So what is global warming? So what is deforestation? Deforestation is nothing but cutting down the trees. And the pollution which comes from the vehicles. So these are the two main things which lead to the global warming. So global warming. So what is global warming? Like our earth has certain temperature. Like in news also we see at the end of the news bulletin, they tell that today's temperature is this. Yes, so our earth has a certain temperature. But because of deforestation, that is cutting down the trees and the smoke which is released from vehicles, factories and all, the temperature is becoming more and more heat. That is, the earth's surface is becoming more and more heat. That is called as global warming. So whatever heat is required for us, the nature is already giving. But what we as human beings, what we are doing, we are polluting the air, we are cutting down the trees, and we are making the earth more and more heat. So that is nothing but global warming. That is, more and more heat is generated. So because of this heat, what happens is the water which is there in the water bodies is evaporated more. It is evaporated more, and because of this only the seasons are also changing. So because of global warming, seasons are changing. So the atmospheric condition is not favorable for clouds to get colder. So because of global warming, it's getting more and more heated. So to cool down, it will take little time. So for the atmosphere to cool down, that is to make rain, they have to cool down, right? So it is taking so much of time. So consequently, there is decrease in rainfall. So this disturbs the water cycle and causes either floods or droughts. So here what is happening, because of this global warming, the clouds are not becoming cool faster, and because of this we are not experiencing the rains in time. So if there are no rains, what happens is sometimes the water bodies, they filled with water and they start moving from that place. So this leads to even floods also, like so much of water coming into the areas or the nearby villages, right? So this is about the lesson. With this we have completed the lesson. Now here, after the lesson, you have the keywords. So read out these keywords, read the complete lesson, and here what you have learned from this lesson, the points are given. Then improve your learning. So these are the question and answers. So I will tell you which question answers you have to write. I will send you the notes. So that question answers you have to write down in the classwork. Hope you all are maintaining the classworks properly. So you have to maintain the index column, write the lesson name, then the keywords, then back of the workbook you have some important facts related to the lesson that you should write. Then the define the following terms will be there, that you should write, and after that you have to write the question answers which I tell you. Yes, so this is about the lesson. This question answers you have to write, what you should write, I will tell you the notes. So not only those, the remaining one also you have to write it down. Right? Each and everything is important, do not leave anything. And from lesson number 2, there was only one picture in the record book. From lesson 3, there are no pictures to do in the record book. But in the workbook near the answers, you will have the diagrams. Or if diagrams are not there, whichever diagram suits to that answer, that diagram you can do. But suppose if any answer is there for water cycle, you can draw the picture of water cycle. If any answer is related to three forms of water, you can do the three forms of water diagram with the pencil. Yes, so like this you have to do it. And in the workbook also, all the bits you have to cover up from page 1 till the last, from the starting of the lesson till the ending of the lesson. Yes, so this is about the lesson. Your homework is to read lesson 3. Read lesson number 3 completely and underline the new words. That new words, you should only write it by your own. Yes, I am not going to give the new words. You have to read the whole lesson and find out 20 new words and write it one time in the classroom. So this is about the lesson. Hope you all have understood till now. Read the lesson thoroughly. Watch the video again and again for a clear description. So thank you. We'll meet in the next session.